We are looking forward to a fabulous auction. We have boards all the way from 1920s, all the way up to 1990.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce the Maestro of Malibu, Mr. Lance Carson. Lance Carson, thanks for coming. Lance Carson, thanks for coming. As you know, there's a variety of sequences in the story behind the movie. A lot of you might know that the actual story behind Lance was the basis for New Wednesday. I hate to say no, that's still on stage. But it is very appropriate that, you know, for the surf shop scene especially, that Lance could make some of the boards with the use of Schaefer Jake, of course. And Lance, give us a little insight into this. We got this next board. It's not really anything super special, but it was made for people to ride.
Right, well, John
Milius
had been surfing Malibu long before he made this movie. And so I've known him for years, and so I was one of the first ones to call him with the idea to do the big Wednesday movie, not only to do some stunt surfing and to make the awards as well. So he called me first, and I commissioned Mike Perry and Robbie Dick from the Malibu area to help do some of the awards. We started out with this board because the first thing we wanted to do, some of the first things they were going to shoot were going to be the shots from inside the surf shop. Now, as most people know, if you're familiar with movie studios, when they call you to do something, they want it done yesterday. This is one of the boards that ended up in the surf shop scene. However, we had started shaping some of the boards, and because the studios wanted to have it done now, they were sending over studio hands and pickup trucks to pick up the first batch of boards so we could stay in the room and shape. Well, they sent these guys out. These guys didn't know anything about surf, freshly shaped surfboard banks, legs, and they were coming in the room with going out to the pickup truck and throwing into the back of the pickup truck. And they were breaking and their noses were busting up. So now they're under pressure to make more boards. Most of the times when you make special boards, high-end boards with all the bells and whistles, you want them to be really nice. Since these were just going to be surf shop props lined up against the wall, they didn't have to be fancy. Nobody's going to be able to feel, and from a distance, you couldn't really see all the fine details. So what they said was, just do the best you can, throw a template on there, shape them up, rough them up, and glass them, and get them in the movie. Well, a lot of times, we, as shapers, when we do a lot of high-end stuff, our pride gets involved, and we want to have a really mission board, and we have a tendency to overshape. We weren't concentrating on that with these, so we were shaping them fast. And when you take all that intensity out of shaping a board like this, it ends up becoming actually better than something you spend a lot of time on. You get it done, and the rails match, and everything looks great. Some of these boards came out really great. I had this in my garage until 2002, until my dad died. I sold it to Matt Calabani because I was unloading a lot of my stuff out of the garage. We had to move out of the house. And Calabani saw this thing and wanted it, and he went into the show. That's a little history about the era. We did about 30 or 40 of these for the movie. I did about 15 or 20.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Let's start. You can't really see it up close, but there's fingerprints on the boards for those guys who are grabbing the board and throwing it in the trunk. Anyway, this is a prop board that Lance shaped for Big Wednesday. Joe, go for it.
14
years old. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as you know, Lance Carson is famous as the Malibu Maestro. What made it really in the magazines was the J.K.S. Lance Carson model. This is considered the best nose rider in Malibu. There was three different generations of these boards. The first ones, they started off with redwood offsets, so you can see this one is balsa. This is the second generation. They were trying to get the boards a little bit lighter, so they went from redwood to balsa. The third generation, they actually went to high density foam. This is probably I've been looking for a Lance Carson Jacobs model. This is the cleanest Lance. I mean, I almost thought this board had never been ridden. It's so clean. Second generation Lance Carson model. You know that Lance, tell you about it. Because Lance is the guy that shaped this board. Everybody knows, they've seen ads, they've seen Lance advertised. Great, swing the fin over, you can see that. I love this thing, they put the pin line on the fin. They had to lay the fin sideways, take this off, and put to the pin line, flipped the board over to the pin line on the other side, and I can't believe it's taken this much time. Nowadays, there's no way you can do that. So this is, look how clean this is. There's no dings. It's almost like brand new. Lance, tell us a little bit about this generation.
It was the mid-60s, everybody was doing signature models, and of course I was working for Hap Jacobs, actually as a salesman out front with Robert Ox. And signature models came in, and they had a gorgeous model, and the big wave of the Phil Edwards Hobie. And I was working sales, and Hap came in one day and says, guys, we want to do a model. We want to do something different. Everybody's doing smart things. And we had a lot of really good guys on Hap's team. We had Rusty Miller, Mike Doyle, Henry Ford, Ricky Hatch, Don Craig, Sparky Hudson, Freddie Fowler, all these guys, Eddie Skyler. They picked me to do a model, okay? So Hap said, okay, the guys wanted you to have a model. The point right from Malibu, that represents the point break. We're gonna have to reshape these. If you were gonna do a signature model, everybody else is doing spur tails, but Lance, you were known with the right to pigtails from Malibu back when I was making ball skins in the late 50s. What do you think? So we got together, and he took me in the shaping room, and we started designing this thing, because there's a couple of guys here that were surfer shapers, and so Hap wanted me to have that privilege and honor to be a writer and a shaper and make these things the way I would write it in Melbourne. And as Randy said, this came from Cape Rootsell, a lot of these things back in the day. And I still got my original 10 foot with the three redwood stringers as we speak in my garage. I rode that thing for 15 years in Malibu and even overhead big ring on low tide. And it was one of those boards that you could get right on the tip and stand there. Separate ways and low tide ring on. And a lot of guys have them.
Let's hang 10 up here.
All right, now I'll say what it used to be. But these boards, we had a lot of fun on. We did them for 2 years, and then our dear friends Bob and Tabs, the Australians, came up with the V-bottom shortboards and put us out of business overnight. But I'm still doing replications of these. I can shake them in Malibu. I'm still doing these in Malibu. I made an agreement with Hap Jacobs to trademark the logo. And I am doing these as replications to this day. But these originally had three redwood stringers in the first 6 months. Then we went to the balsa stringers, which is what is in the final series. We went from a yellow pin to a black pin with a yellow pin line. This is like one of the mid-range in a two-year period of radius. This is one of the second series. But this is the original. And I shaped this one because when I came in, the first thing I did, I checked the numbers because all the shapers had different penmanship when they put the pencil mark on the balsa stringer. That's one of mine. I did that.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lance Carson. 28-109, 28-109, if you're not front row, you're out. 29-3, 29-3, the last Carson, your chance. 3, up to 35, 31, now 2, now 2, now 2, now 2, now 2, now 2, everybody's out. On the line, 7, and 2, no game to live Washington, 3. So, $3,500 to the young man, 28-10.
Thank you for coming to our 6th Hawaiian Vintage Surf Auction.